Dear students, in this lecture we will discuss about three kinds of free radicals: NH2, that is amino free radical, hydrogen N2H3 free radical, and phosphinyl free radicals, that are pH and pH2. So we will discuss their preparation, their properties, and there are some general characteristics in this lecture. So first, let's discuss about amino free radical. The amino radical is the neutral form of azanide ion. So this NH2 has negative charge, so this is an ion, and when then NH2 has an odd electron, that it is amino radical. So it is the neutral form of azanide ion. It can also be called as aminyl, azanyl, dihydridonitrogen radical. So these are the other names of this radical. It is highly reactive and very short-lived radical. So it reacts very fast, therefore it is a short-lived free radical. It has two electronic states. One is 2B1 and other is named as 2A1. So what is the difference between these two states? So in this state, you will find that this lone pair of electron is present in the sp2 hybridized orbital of nitrogen, while this unpaired electron is present in the p orbital that is perpendicular to the plane of this NH2 radical. Okay. And now in this case, in case of 2AA1 state, you will find that this electron pair is present in the p orbital that is perpendicular to the plane of the molecule, while the unpaired electron is present in the sp2 hybridized orbital. So because this unpaired electron is present in the sp2 hybridized orbital, which can easily form a sigma bond, so this radical is also named as sigma type radical. While this 2B1 radical, the unpaired electron is present in this p orbital, which can form pi bond, so it is also known as pi type radical. And the electronic state, that is 2B1, and it is known as pi type radical, it is more stable as compared to this state. In both the state, you will find there is one unpaired electron, but the most stable state is that where the electron pair is present in the sp hybridized orbital. And this amino radical is nucleophilic in nature due to the presence of nitrogen. Now we will discuss about the methods of preparation of amino radical. So there are several ways with the help of which this amino radical can be prepared. So the first method is the photolysis of ammonia. So the ammonia on photolysis at about this 1849 angstrom, it forms amino free radical and hydrogen free radical. And below 1550 angstrom, this ammonia on photolysis, it results amino radical along with the imine radical. So both kind of radicals will be formed. The second method of preparation of amino radical is the reaction of ammonia with methyl, hydroxyl, or hydrogen free radicals. So ammonia, when reacts with this hydroxyl free radical, it will form H2O. With the methyl free radical, it will form CH4. And with the H radical, it will form H2 along with this amino free radical. It can also be prepared from hydroxyl amine. And from hydroxyl amine is the oxidation reduction reaction, which we have studied in the general methods of preparation of free radicals. So here hydroxylamine, when reacts with this titanium, it will form amino free radical. So these products may be formed. This can be written as this Di3+OH also. So here, through the transfer of one electron from here to this, it will form this amino free radical, and this Ti3+ will convert into Ti4+. So this is a kind of one electron transfer and oxidation reduction reaction which produces the amino free radical. Now the amino free radical can also be synthesized from hydrogen. So if we pyrolyze hydrogen or flame on flame decomposition, hydrogen can form two molecules of amino free radical. It can also formed from ammoniumyl ion. So this ammoniumyl ion, it can produce amino radical, or it can react with NH3, and here the NH3 will abstract hydrogen from ammoniumyl ion and then form this amino free radical. Amino free radical can also be formed by the thermal decomposition of benzylamine. So this is the benzylamine, and when the increase in the temperature, this will form benzyl radical and amino radical. So these are the simple methods of preparation for amino free radical. Now we will discuss about the reactions shown by amino free radicals. So now we will discuss about the reactions of amino free radical, and its reactivity generally depends upon the pH of the reaction medium. Generally they are reactive in the pH range of 3 to 7. It means generally they are reactive at acidic pH range, but with organic molecules the pH range is near 11 to 12 pH, and they can easily react with the organic molecules. So this study has been deeply studied by Netta et al. In 1978, where they found that this amino free radical can react with phenols, hydroquinones, resorcinols, and other organic molecules. So this is the reaction showing the reaction of amino free radical with the organic molecule. So we have shown the reaction with the phenol. A range of reactions, that of phenols, hydroquinones, other phenol derivatives, aniline, resorcinol, have been studied by Netta et al. In 1978, and in this reaction they have taken 4 to 10 millimolar concentration of phenol and 1.5 mNH3, and the pH range was from 11.3 to 12, then the reaction will generate the phenoxyl radical and ammonia. So the amino free radical can easily react with the organic compounds. Amino radicals also show recombination reactions. So they can react with a number of other free radicals. So when amino react with this free radical, it will form the neutral molecule. So these are recombination reactions with the other free radicals, and this can be termed as the dimerization. So this dimerization produces hydrogen. Then the next reaction is disproportionation reaction, and this disproportionation reaction you have shown in the imine free radical also, where you have find that the one oxidation state will simultaneously converts into two oxidation states, and the two oxidation states, and where you will find that in the one reaction there will be oxidation, and in other reaction there will be a reduction. So here this N is having the oxidation state -2, in this it is having -3, and in this it is having -1. So -2 will convert into -1, so this is oxidation. -2 is converting into -3, so this is reduction. So this kind of reaction is known as disproportionation reaction. This amino radical, it can also react with oxygen, and with oxygen it can form different kinds of products. Then it can also react with nitric oxide, and with nitric oxide it will form nitrogen and water molecule. Now what is the impact of these free radicals on human health? So if we see, I have already given you some introductory idea about the free radicals in the first part of the inorganic free radicals lecture, and here I will also again repeat, because this amino free radical, it is very important free radical, and it also generates in the human body. And in the human body, there is a balancing mechanism, because some materials are there which can act as antidotes for these radicals. So if any excessive amount of free radicals will generate, then the excessive amount of the free radicals can be cancelled out by the balancing mechanism in the human body. But in excessive, very excessive amount, the very excessive amount of these free radicals, it can be generated through metabolic processes. It is the normal process. But if we find the excessive amount, it is due to the exposure to the X-rays, cigarette smokes, industrial chemicals. So this excessive amount becomes very toxic in nature, and we have to take some antioxidant from the outside, because our the mechanism inside the human body is made for a certain amount of radicals, not for the excessive amount of radicals. So after a certain point, they become toxic in the human body, so we have to take some antioxidant to neutralize these free radicals. Okay, so amino radicals are generally, they are also carcinogenic. They induce DNA damage and they react with the DNA of human body. So due to the reaction with the DNA, they causes mutation and they causes transformation, and ultimately they can cause the cancer. So we have to take the antioxidants that are used to neutralize the free radicals. Through the antioxidants, they can act to neutralize the free radical through electron donation, metal ion chelation, gene expression regulation. So these are the different methods through which antioxidants can regulate the amount of free radicals in the human body. So the amino radicals, because they are very carcinogenic in nature, so if they will generate in excessive amount in the human body, so they will become the carcinogenic. So we have to take some antioxidants to neutralize their effect. Now the second radical we will discuss is hydrogen radical, which is N2H3, and you can see that here is one unpaired electron in this radical. This free radical is also called as diagenyl or hydragenyl free radical. It is one electron species, so it is having one electron. So it is again paramagnetic in nature, and it can return as this also, NH, NH2. So this is the another structural form of hydrogen radical. The odd electron present in the hydrogen free radical can be delocalized between two nitrogen atoms. So like this unpaired electron may present on this nitrogen atom, or this unpaired electron may present on this nitrogen atom. So in this way, you will find that there is three electron bond in hydrogen radical. These are the methods of preparation for hydrogen free radical. So this hydrogen can be photolyzed in presence of light, and it can form hydrogen free radical and hydrogen free radical. The next method is the reaction of hydrogen free radical with hydrogen. So it will also produce hydrogen free radical and H2. In the third method, again you will find the use of hydrogen. So it is very simple to learn about the preparation methods of hydrogen, because in each preparation you will find the use of hydrogen. So one is simply the photolysis of hydrogen, the other is the reaction of hydrogen with the H free radical, and the third one is the reaction of this hydrogen with the methyl or amino free radical, which helps in synthesizing the hydrogen free radical. So CH3 react with hydrogen to form CH4, and this amino free radical will react with this hydrogen to form hydrogen free radical and ammonia. So with the evolution of methane and ammonia, the hydrogen free radical can be formed by the reaction of hydrogen with methyl free radical and hydrogen with amino free radical. respectively. The properties or reactions of hydrogen free radicals. The hydrogen free radicals, they takes part in dimerization. So at minus 178 degree centigrade, the hydrogen free radical dimerize, and because this unpaired electron will bind to the unpaired electron of this nitrogen center, so such kind of product will be formed, because we know that NH-NH2 is the hydrogen and NH-NH2 is one hydrogen, so bond between these can easily formed because both has one unpaired electron. Now the other kind of reactions of hydrogen is that they can produce nitrogen, and the production of nitrogen is generally exothermic reaction. So this hydrogen itself converts into nitrogen, hydrogen and hydrogen free radical. When reacts with hydrogen free radical, it forms N2N2H2, and when reacts with amino free radical, it again produces nitrogen. All these reactions, they are exothermic reaction. The other method for the production of nitrogen is the when the 2N2H3 they combine, they sometimes they cannot dimerize, but they can actually, you can see that they can form the N2. So again, this is exothermic reaction and very fast reaction. So the two molecules, they can add up to form N2, or they can dimerize. So both these kind of reaction can takes place in case of this hydrogen free radical. Then reaction with hydrogen free radical produces the amino free radical. So this hydrogen free radical is also a source of amino free radical. Now we will discuss about the phosphinyl free radicals, that includes PH and PH2. The PH2 ligand is also called as phosphinyl phosphino or dihydridophosphorus radical. It is having one unpaired electron, while this PH is having two unpaired electrons. So how these can be prepared? The method of preparation is generally, it originates from phosphine, because these two radicals, they originates from phosphine, so they can be prepared from phosphine. And this phosphine is part of Jupiter. It is present in the Jupiter. So there, these kind of reactions, they takes place. Okay, so these can be prepared by the photolysis, electric discharge or pyrolysis of phosphine. The reaction of phosphine with OH free radical, it occurs in the atmosphere also. So this phosphine, when reacts with this OH free radical, it can form PH2 free radical, or this PH3 when reacts with this hydrogen free radical, it again can form PH2 free radical. And if we see the reactions, then we will find that this phosphinyl ligand, this radical, it cannot dimerize. In spite of dimerization, it causes disproportionation reaction. Okay, so again you will find this is the preparation method of PH also, and when these two phosphinyl radicals, they react, they don't dimerize, they disproportionate to PH3 and PH. So in PH2, this is having minus 2 oxidation is set, so it is converting into minus 3 and minus 1. So one is reduction and other is oxidation. So this is a kind of disproportionation reaction. The other disproportionation reaction where P2 and H2 will form. The second kind of reactions shown by these phosphinyl ligands is polymerization initiation reaction. So they can polymerize. They can initiate the polymerization reaction and can easily react with the olefins. So this PH2, when reacts with this olefin, it will create, it will generate a free radical, and then this free radical can again undergo the chain reactions, and at the termination point, this can react finally with the this phosphinyl ligand and then form the product. So this is helpful in the chain initiation reaction. So now we will summarize the whole lecture on amino radical, hydrogen and phosphinyl free radicals. So we have studied about the amino free radical. Amino free radical is a very important free radical because it plays a vital role in human health also, and it causes cancerous diseases. Okay, so we have studied their electronic states, and we find that 2B1 is the most stable electronic state where the electron pair was present on the sp2 hybridized orbital, while the unpaired electron was present on the p orbital, that is perpendicular to the plane of the molecule. Then we have studied the different preparation methods, and preparation methods generally involve the ammonia, the reaction of ammonia, the pyrolysis, photolysis of ammonia, or the reaction of ammonia with the other free radicals. And one other preparation method involves the oxidation reduction reaction, that is the reaction of NH2OH with Ti3+, then the pyrolysis of hydrogen and thermal decomposition of benzylamine. So these are the different methods of preparation of amino free radical. Then we have studied the reactions, and they because amino free radical is a very important free radical, it easily reacts with the organic compounds at a particular pH range, and they show the recombination reactions with the other free radicals. They can react with oxygen, they can react with nitric oxide, and they can easily disproportionate. Now we have studied about the other free radical, that is hydrogen free radical. So this hydrogen free radical is another important free radical where there is one unpaired electron. It can also return as NH-NH2, and the odd electron was delocalized among two nitrogen atoms. The preparation method involved the use of hydrogen. So that is photolysis of pyrogen, reaction with the other free radicals like hydrogen free radical, methyl free radical and amino free radical. And if we see the properties of hydrogen free radical, then we will find that these can dimerize, they can react with the other free radicals, so they are helpful in the production of nitrogen. And they can also be used for the synthesis of amino free radical. Then we have studied about the phosphinyl ligands. We have studied two phosphinyl ligands. One is BH and other is BH2. One is having one unpaired electron and the BH is having two unpaired electrons. They can be generated from phosphines. So photolysis of phosphine, reaction of phosphine with the hydrogen free radical or hydroxyl free radical. And then in the reactions, we have studied only two kind of reactions, that are disproportionation reactions and polymerization reactions, because they can easily initiate the polymerization reaction and can easily react with the olefinic compounds. So this is all about the free radicals. Three free radicals we have covered in this lecture. That are amino free radical, hydrogen free radical and phosphinyl free radicals. So thank you very much.